して寝ちゃいましたもんね。
The casino racing section eliminated only a small group of hopefuls. And although conditions have forced slow times, all the top contenders are through and well placed. Derek Pinoy and Jack Purchase start off first on day two, 30 seconds ahead of second man Klaus Degener. Brother Gert in his Range Rover Bucky follows. With the big 4x4 trucks, Philip Malone and Brian Holt start seventh, 2 minutes off the pace, while Arpi Reinecker starts ninth. Saturday morning, and as dawn breaks over the Venda Hills, the drivers prepare for the 7 a.m. start. Kilometers into the race, and the Chenalth of Preziati and Swanepoel now lead. Pinoy and Purchase chase hard, followed by Klaus Degener, Bruce Carolyn, and Gert Degener. Philip Malone's Land Cruiser is up to sixth place, with Draper's Nissan Safari seventh. The muddy forest roads favor the trucks in these early stages, as the midfield competitors fight to keep their places. Trying too hard can be fatal, as Gert and Jacques find out the hard way. Their race ends only 70 kilometers from the start, where the bike boys prepare to do battle only minutes away from their 9 a.m. start. We pick the race up on the dry back section with the cars heading east. Klaus Degener now in front, having greater top speed on the Chenalths. Springbok rally navigator Piet Swanepoel has his first taste of an open car. Back at Toyondu, and Willie Ireland comes under starter's orders. This is the only view the rest of the riders will see of Willie, who is to dominate the first 200 kilometers. Cox sets off. Ahead of Davies. Championship leader Kevin Tebbutt has an anxious wait before he too is released into the section. With road surfaces now dry and fast, longer legs outsmart handling. Linton Draper's big Nissan easily takes second place away from Preziati. Route Control D, situated off the main road, records fourth-placed Philip Malone, but has no recording of car 900 Klaus Degener. Klaus failed to take the turn-off as the roads rejoin. This mistake will push him 20 minutes ahead of the field, but earning him a 60-minute penalty. On entering the service area, Klaus is still well in the lead, despite being lost for a while. The German driver is unaware of his mistake, and that his brother is suffering a severely crushed hand. For Klaus, things appear to be going well. But Klaus heads off to disaster. His service crew have topped his fuel tanks with water. A devastating mistake. With Hannes Schrobler out of off-road racing, the trucks seem more closely matched, as navigator Piet Swanepoel has moved from cab to open air, a new experience for the national champ.
From what they tell me, I'm going to be in for it today. And I've never been in a sandmast, and they tell me it can get pretty, pretty wet in there, so I'm prepared for the worst, and I'll put on my raincoat and see where it goes.
Surprisingly, Fred Levesque is up with the leaders.
It's harder for a privateer. You've got to be more careful. You've got to watch your bucks every time. You know, for me, I've probably spent on my total car more than the average guy, sponsored guy, spends on his engine or something like that.
Fred is in good company with Harry Roscoe and Bruce Carolyn as he heads off on the northern section to the most distant point of the route and along the rough Kruger National Park border. For many, the slow sections will prove too rough as suspensions, wheels and tyres take a hammering. The vendor is known for its cross-section of conditions and long list of retirements. Pinoy and Purchase have spent a frustrating morning sorting out the Chinath, and unlike others ahead of them, their troubles are over. As the back markers rattle and bump their way to the service area, Willie Ireland and his KTM pop into sight. Now in a commanding lead, Ireland has seen nothing of the drama behind him. Kevin Tibbett, riding at a steady pace, has lost contact with Ireland, but holds a comfortable second place. With the National 250cc Championship in the bag, Hilton Beatty is literally riding for fun and doing a good job of keeping third spot secure. In sixth place, Jeremy Davies chases Jake Alberts and Alfie Cox. Jeremy overshot the first refuel point while only seconds behind the leading riders. Stranded without fuel, Davies could only watch as the competition flew past. Eventually, it was Cox who stopped and helped get Davies on his way. Degener, in his King Scorpion, is going, but having lost over an hour on the side of the road, his race is all but run. The northeastern section is tough and slowly takes its toll. Swinging back from the east, Philip Malon and Brian Holt have put 10 minutes of daylight between themselves and those behind. The Nissan Challenge dies as R.P. Reinecke retires and Linton Draper parks, bonnet up, with electrical problems. This gives Johan Steenkamp and Louis Joubert in their Land Cruiser a shot at second spot. Driving at a steady pace, the big 4x4 still sounds and looks good. Johan could make it a first and second for Toyota. But now, only minutes behind, Derek and Jack have pulled themselves up to third. Having rid themselves of the gremlins that slowed them earlier, the duo are after that second place. This very successful outfit needs sponsorship for 1988, and every placing counts. It was this little special that broke the domination of the trucks and started a swing across two twin-seater specials, a class that now boasts one of the largest entries. One of those entries is the Lesotho-based team of Ashley Thorne and Jan Koss, seen here in fourth place, but with plenty of trouble on their tail in the form of Harry Roscoe. But Harry's challenge is short-lived, as only a few kilometers down the track, a blown diff puts the single-seater out of the race. Back in the rough stuff, and Kevin Tibbett emerges as the leader. Riding a controlled race, Kevin inherited the front spot from Willie Ireland, when the young rider had to slow with a faulting engine. The heat and sandy conditions caused the KTM to seize, forcing Ireland to slow his pace. With a South African championship online, no one is more aware of the situation than Kevin himself. But the finish line lies many kilometres to the southwest, and a very irate Davies is out there somewhere. With the midday temperature in the late 30s, dehydration becomes a real threat for the riders. Hilton Beatty gratefully drinks from the Marshall's water bottle, now able to face the 100 kilometers to the finish. At the finish, Malone and Holt swing the Land Cruiser into the champion winner's enclosure. Having been on the road for 6 hours, 49 minutes and 53 seconds, the Toyota crew have pulled off an unchallenged win, and both vehicle and occupants are in decidedly good shape. Tebbutt glides the KTM through the river, having kept the 5-minute barrier between himself and Davies. Davies is riding like a man possessed, and try as he may, his efforts seem lost on catching Tebbutt. Johan Steenkamp thunders in under the finish banner, 10 minutes behind the leaders, an honourable drive that secures a first and second for Toyota. Only 2 minutes behind the second Toyota, 12 minutes off the winning time, Derek Pinoy and Jack Purchase have fought back boldly and take a very honourable third. Also third, but still with plenty of work on his hands, Hilton Beatty and his Yamaha race for the finish. The Sutton pair of Frank and Dean have redeemed their efforts of the previous day and may well earn a finisher's badge after all. While at the finish, an anxious crowd await the arrival of the first motorcycle home. A cheer goes up for Kevin Tebbutt as he ends the race and endorses his name on the championship trophy. He's been totally unaware of the threat Davies slowly presented, and his pace as leader, although a natural one, never let him down. A truly worthy winner and a wonderful ride. For young Jeremy, the mistake of missing a refuel point has possibly cost him the South African title. His face, masked by frustration, Jeremy's challenging effort has been sporting to the end. Hard luck stories will flow over drinks at the Vendersun prize giving for Willie Ireland and Klaas Degener, both of whom had led their respective races to the halfway point. The last race of 1987 will have been a bitter disappointment. Willie must nurse the KTM home to register an official finish, while Klaas, in missing the checkpoint, faces a 1-hour penalty over and above his problems. Philip Malone and Brian Holt have ended the season on a high note, having won the Roof of Africa Rally in September and now the champion Vendersun 500. The class winners have done well, and a win in Class 3 by Angus and Tierbus gives Toyota the manufacturer's prize. Kevin Tebbutt wins with Davies in second place, a margin of just over 3 minutes in time. Cox finishes fourth, ahead of Atkinson and Fisher. Beatty wins the 250cc class, while Malcolm McDermott wins class 11. With Reinecke retired and Degener out of the running, Fred Levesque's class 10 win earns the budget special the national championship title.